Evening, everyone. It's Monday evening, 7:20, a little on the late side, but I wanted to absorb some information. This is video number 730, and it is your Monday 4:26 closing comment. Well, everybody waited for Tesla, and here's what happened. They beat top and bottom, not by big amounts. And the stock, of course, has had a reasonable little run. It had closed 738.20, up $8.80 at the end of the day. After the earnings, it traded both up to 750, which was a new high on the day, and down to 698, which was a new low on the day. And then as the actual call started, it moved back up to about 724, and it looks like the close was 720. That was down 540 after being up 880, so some of it may look like down 13, but in point of fact, it was only down $5, 1.2%. We'll have to see what kind of further information comes out tomorrow, but in general, it was pretty much as expected. Amazon was up 69.12 at 34.09. There are some rumors around that on Thursday when they report their earnings that they may announce a stock split, and so everybody's very excited about that. Otis, the elevators, beat top and bottom line. Had traded this morning after the earnings, 74 up 272, managed to close 76.27 up 499 or 7% at the end of the day. And Albertsons, ACI, missed on revenues, beat on earnings. This morning was 18.40 down 78 cents. Got down as low as another 70 cents lower at 1773, but managed to close at 1822 down 96, or, you know, in the general area that it was this morning. The big surprise was Lennox, LII, which beat top and bottom line, and this morning was trading 351 and change, up almost 17 or 5.1. However, during the day, the high was only 348 and the low was 320, and it actually closed 332.49, down $1.97, which is kind of a surprise from, you know, 351 and change. We have a lot of earnings tomorrow. We have CNC, Centene, we have GE, and this is all pre-open. Centene, GE, 3M, JetBlue, Roper, ADM, which nobody really thinks about much, but Archer Daniel Midland should really be profiting by the inflation in grain prices especially, and RTX, which is Raytheon. In after the market, we have AMD, Alphabet, Microsoft, Pinterest, Starbucks, and Visa. We did have a bunch of market economic news today. We had March durable goods, which were a disappointment, up 0.5% versus 2.2% expected. Ex-transportation up 1.6, about as expected. Defense, ex-airlines, ex-airplanes, up 0.9%, also as expected. Japan's LEI was a big disappointment, came in at 0.6% versus an estimate double that of 1.2. Tomorrow we also have consumer confidence, we have housing prices, and we also have Case-Shiller. The markets were mixed, and even though the Dow was down 62, we actually had 1.8-1 up stocks. And this is something that's happened in the last couple of weeks several times, where the market internals are upset by a couple of stocks being down. Today, My recollection is Honeywell, 3M, which reports tomorrow pre-open, were weights on the Dow. NASDAQ was up 122, or 8/10, or almost 9/10%. And the advanced declines there were 2.2 to 1. The volume, by the way, on the NYSE was almost 3 to 1 up. So I'm going to guess that unless there's some big surprises tomorrow, that we'll get kind of back in sync there. The S&P was up 7.5. The Dow Jones transports were down 38. And the big gainer on the day was the Russell, up 26.15, or 1.15%. As far as futures go, the chart on the screen is the only one worth discussing today, or the most exciting one, and that is Bitcoin. Overnight, we were down on Saturday in the cash market and Sunday, and we opened to the downside, and the low on the day in the futures last night, electronic session, 47,440, which was down about 3,700. And it opened and ran straight up to 54,410. So that's pretty amazing, almost a $7,000 range on a $47,000 commodity. That's about 16% range in the day. Closed very close to the high, up 3225 at 54,070. As I said, that's pretty close to the high. It was about 340 off the high, and it was about 7,000 off the low. So pretty decent. Not much action tonight. The gold was down to up to down to finally closing about unchanged at 1780.10, up $2.30. And we added a position today in UNG. I've mentioned it a couple of times that that's the ETF for natural gas. I'm bullish in the long term on natural gas. And Tellurian. Tellurian, by the way, today, we added to it at $1.66 the other day, and it closed today $2.20, up 29 cents, or just over 15%. And this chart is the net gas itself. I was concerned that it might come out of this little island to the downside. It started that way this morning, but then rallied all morning and managed to close practically on the high and above most of these other, well, highest trade and highest close here. Previous high close in this little area was 283.10. Today's close was 287.40, up 560. Tonight, it's doing really very little of anything. 287.90 is the high so far tonight, so we have another half dollar to go to break that out. If we break to the upside here, I'm going to say we certainly will try the $3 area. But the UNG calls that we bought at 35 cents today closed 52 cents. They're the tens. And so if we get a continuation move here up to $3, that'll give us about probably 10.75 to 11 on the stock. That would be a dollar in the money for a call that we paid 35 cents for today. All right, everyone, have a good evening. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll be back first thing in the morning.